The woman came to the secret room and saw an ugly scene through the door. Her husband and her son's girlfriend. She couldn't take it. She went to the center of the river and pointed a gun at herself. As a flock of white birds rose, the mother's body floated to the surface. Matthew was too late after his mother died. Matthew packed his bags and left home. His brother Charlie followed, pleading with his brother not to leave, but he was determined and marched on without looking back. 13 years passed. Matthew, now a war correspondent, heard of his father's death and traveled from Europe to attend the funeral. But when he got to the church, he didn't take a step. He hid in the corner and waited for the funeral to be over. Then he came to his brother's house and saw him return. Charlie was so happy to see his brother back. He asked his wife to make up the room and keep him for a few more days. But for Matthew, the brotherly love was very strange after so many years, so he refused his brother's kind offer on the grounds that he had already found a hotel. The next day, the brothers divided up the estate. Charlie told Matthew that his father had divided the estate into three parts, one for each of the brothers, and when it came to the third share, he stopped talking and lowered his head to turn the ring on his hand. Matthew thought his brother was in financial trouble and wanted more. So he said he'd give him his share, and that he might have to leave tomorrow because of his job. Charlie was very angry because of the death of his mother. Matthew just left, leaving him in this deformed and painful family, and now he wants to do it again. That to have a big fight. Matthew went back to his father's old house, looking through the dusty photo albums, which still have reports from his time in the war zone. It turns out that his father had been watching over him all these years. In addition, he found a picture of a baby. Matthew's pretty sure it's not him, and it's not his brother. But who is he? With this question in mind, Matthew decided to stay here to find out the truth. And when he came to the supermarket to do some shopping, he met his former teacher and learned that Matthew was a war correspondent. The teacher immediately invited him to give a speech at the school, but he didn't realize that the girl, Emily, was also in the audience. 2 days ago, Matthew came to the cabin to pack up his things and found the girl listening to a song and writing, so he scolded her and left. He didn't hear the girl say that her mom was always here. Emily has always been an ambitious girl, so she admires Matthew. In order to follow in the footsteps of her idol, she even went online to collect information about him and his exploits. But when Emily's mom found out, she wasn't so sure. The former lovers met again, leaving behind only regret and nostalgia. It turns out that after Matthew left, his girlfriend got pregnant. Although she didn't say so, Matthew found out from the bracelet she was wearing. In the photo, the bracelet holding the baby is exactly the same as his girlfriend's. In other words, the baby could be hers. At once, the sheer volume of information was almost too much for him to handle, and he found Miranda the next day. The baby was born 8 months after he left, so it couldn't be her husband's. But no matter how hard he pressed, the woman wouldn't tell him who the father was. If you can't do it this way, you can do it another way. Matthew found out that the baby was Emily, the one he saw at his father's cabin. Calculating the time of birth, Matthew was sure that Emily was his daughter. What he couldn't figure out was why Miranda wouldn't tell him. In order to make up for his daughter's lack of fatherly love, Matthew decides to agree to the teacher's invitation to stay at the school as a teaching assistant. Matthew started to get close to Emily, knowing that she loved to hear war stories, so he picked the best ones and set up an assignment to interview himself. And it worked out just as he had hoped. The next morning, Dorner came over. Matthew's joy was unmistakable, and he communicated with her in a very cordial way, talking at great length throughout the day. The two of them talked as if they were friends, but getting too close eventually led to trouble. When Miranda found out they were meeting in private, she was furious. She kicked her daughter home and warned Matthew not to come near her again. Matthew said, "Is it against the law for a father to meet his daughter?" Miranda's eyes dodged, and she left the place in a panic, as if she was hiding some secret. Emily didn't show up at school the next day. Matthew was uneasy and came home to visit her, but found her face was full of injuries. Emily told him that she was beaten by her father and that he was very perverted. He used to go to the bathroom when she was taking a shower. Matthew heard, immediately rushed into the house to find the man to settle the score, but did not expect to be thrown out by the other side. Seeing the man so worried about his own safety, Emily liked this teacher even more. That day, Matthew took Emily out for a picnic. He went to the car to get some water. He dropped his wallet on the ground. Emily opened it and found her childhood photo inside. Her doubts were answered. She cried and asked her mother if Matthew was her real father.
I wish it were that simple.
The girl disappeared for no reason. Matthew, who was suspected to be her biological father, became the prime suspect. He said that Emily had probably gone to Paris. He said Emily could have gone to Paris because he had given her a redemption ticket to go anywhere. and Paris was one of the cities she longed for the most. Hearing that her mother Miranda told the police that her daughter was most likely being hidden by Matthew, and that she had always suspected that Emily was her child, approaching on purpose on several occasions. Upon returning home, Miranda found the passport from her suitcase. This meant that her daughter hadn't left the country, but the police searched everywhere and still couldn't find any traces. The police suspected that Matthew had killed her, and with the pressure of public opinion, Matthew lost his job and was attacked by the townspeople as a pedophile. Even his nephew Jason looked at him with disgust. Matthew became a street rat and spent his days hiding in his house, taking medication to relieve his depression. Seeing his nephew's disdain for him, Matthew explained that he was innocent. It turns out that Jason has always loved Emily, and when he hears about his uncle and him, he can't accept it. Seeing him lose control of his emotions, Matthew had to tell the truth that Emily might be his daughter. After calming down, Jason also told Matthew an important clue. He saw his father hiding a backpack. He thought it was to help his uncle to hide the evidence, but unexpectedly, the secret hidden inside turned everyone's imagination upside down. Matthew then asked his brother to the river, holding a gun to force the other side to explain everything. It turns out, his father's third inheritance was left to Emily, who is not Matthew's daughter but their sister. When he came back from school, he found his mother quietly heading to the cabin. He followed her to the cabin and saw his father and Miranda's sordid affair. After his mother committed suicide, after his mother killed herself, he buried the secret. His father told him the truth on his deathbed and gave Emily a share of his inheritance. Charlie, already upset about the affair, saw Emily as a thorn in his side when he found out that his son was also in love with her. So while working on a file, his wife pushed him down the stairs. Matthew was paralyzed when he learned the truth. He never thought it would end this way. This movie is in my father's den. It's the first time our Matthew Macfadyen has set foot in his hometown in over a decade, and he's here for no other reason than to attend his father's funeral. Andrew Coley Moy, Bauer's older brother, is not happy about his brother's visit, as time has made people strangers and their different personalities have created conflict. At Andrew's urging, Bauer travels to his father's cabin to settle his father's estate, where he meets a young girl named Celia Emily Barclay. This is Seahorse Movie. Goo 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 goo.